Good evening, YouTube. You guys are watching another segment of the Cali Effect, King of Games. And today, we're going to be watching an epic match between me piloting heroes against TJ and, of course, Synchro Quasar Control, or whatever you want to call it, because this deck is awesome. If you guys want to see both of these, a deck profile of the Elemental Hero build, then go ahead and click on this annotation right here. That'll take you right to the Elemental Hero build, and that will show you how powerful this deck can be, as well as his live duel, so I hope you guys really enjoy it. I'm going to go ahead and win the dice roll and then decide to go first, because obviously winning the dice roll and going first is probably the most miraculous thing you can do in Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm gonna go ahead and normal summon Elemental Hero Solid Man, then use this effect to spread summon Elemental Hero Shadow Mist from my hand to my side of the field. That's gonna trigger Elemental Hero Shadow Mist's effect to add Mash Change from my deck to my hand. And everybody knows what Mash Change does, but we'll be able to explain its effects just a little later when I actually start using it. More importantly, I want to get into an Esol, so I'm gonna set three cards face down and then special summon from my hand to my side of the field Elemental Hero Bubble Man. Now this monster's really good because when I control no other monster, or when I have no other monster cards in my hand, I can spend some of them, and he allowed me to tutor Esol to my side of the field without having to use my Shadow Mist. Now, Esol's effect is going to activate. I'm going to send four equipped spells, not one, not two, not three, but four equipped spells from my deck to my graveyard. Moon Mirror Shoe, Divine Sword, Phoenix Blade, possibly a Horn of the Unicorn, and Big Bang Shot. To special summon Vision Hero Vion from my deck to my side of the field. Vion's effect is going to trigger to allow me to send one hero monster from my deck to the graveyard. With that, I'm going to send Destiny Hero Malicious. And now my board is a little bit different than what people would normally think of the board. You want to start off with Elemental Hero Solid Man and Vision Hero Vion. That's going to, you know, get you the board that you want. But I'm going to go ahead and special summon Destiny Hero Malicious to my side of the field. And that card is really important still to the strategy. I might not be able to Notoria Beast him because I don't have Solid Man to make that monster to my side of the field. But I can use the Destiny Hero Malicious and the Esol Two Tails of the Noble Knights for a Link Summon again, and I'm still going to special summon Summon Sorceress to my side of the field. I apologize for you European players. Your combo sequence would probably end right there. Not really great, but at least you still have a Dark Law. This time around, I'm going to make Summon Sorceress use its effect, targeting my Vision Hero Vion to special summon a monster from my deck to my side of the field. I think this time around, I actually get the opportunity to special summon my second copy of Elemental Hero Bubble Man, and just like a quick shout of how powerful Elemental Hero Bubble Man is in multiples in this deck still, because you can still gain his attribute, and that's really important. I'm gonna go ahead and then follow up with my next play using Vision Hero Vion's effect to banish probably the other Elemental Hero Bubble Man in my graveyard to search polymerization from my deck to my hand. And polymerization is actually really powerful in this deck as well. I'll be able to explain to you why it's so good a little later. But we're still waiting on Cali Effect to actually perform the action of banishing Vision Hero Vion. He's looking through it. Yes, he's gonna banish the Bubble Boy. Not really, it wouldn't be necessary this time around, because if I did draw the Miracle Fusion, I kind of wouldn't be able to go into it. So I'm gonna add polymerization from my deck to my hand. And the reason why polymerization is so important to the strategy is because not only does it allow me to get Destiny Hero cards if I were to hard draw Malicious out of my hand, but it's also a free card for the add from your Vision Hero Vion, and it's a fusion summon for free cards. It's a very, very powerful card. As you guys can see, I'm thinking about how I can make this absolute zero using Bubble Man, and I'm thinking I'm have to do a Destiny Hero monster, and then like I start to think, I'm like, wait, no, my absolute zero actually predates any other hero monsters other than Destiny Hero, Evil Hero, and Elemental Hero. So I'm gonna use my polymerization fusing Vision Hero Vion and Elemental Hero Bubble Man to make Elemental Hero absolute zero. My original print absolute zero says one Evil Hero, one Destiny Hero, one Elemental Hero. So we're kind of having a little bit of controversy because Vision Hero Vion is not either of those. It's a Vision Hero, and we have to like look it up just to verify, like, does Absolute Zero actually say a hero, or is it really specific to those cards? Which is no problem. I can still banish the Destiny Hero Malicious to summon Destiny Hero Malicious to my side of the field and keep the Vion, but I would prefer to use the Vion right now for the Absolute Zero because it wouldn't be doing anything. but taking up space. TJ is actually on his phone looking it up right now for us just to verify. And he's going to say, yeah, it's all good. It actually says hero on its card text. So I'm going to go ahead and pass it back to him. There's just a good thing that I want to point out. You guys might want to have updated text on your cards, or look up the updated text on your cards so you won't get a little confused inside of your duels, because Absolute Zero does predate the other hero monsters. On my opponent's turn, I'm going to flip up that mass change using Shadow Mist for Masked Hero Dark Law. So essentially, I have a Raigeki on my side of the field, and I have a Microcosmos, and then I'm going to trigger my Shadow Mist effect to add one elemental hero monster from my, or one hero monster from my deck to my hand. So I got quite a bit of advantage through that. I was able to search a hero card and also search a mash change card, all off of the effects of Isol, being able to summon the elemental hero Shadow Mist. TJ's not really in a good position. He's going to activate Reinforcement of the Army to try to search a warrior monster from his deck to his hand. He's going to try to follow up with a Terraforming. I'm like, nah, homie, you gotta search the Rota first. Stop stacking them together. I got Dark Law on the field. So Dark Law's effect is going to activate anytime an opponent's monster, or anytime an opponent searches a card from the deck to the hand, I get to banish a card from their hand. So I think he should start off with the Terraforming first, because I don't think he uses Terraforming in this combo sequence, or in this combo sequence he's trying to build, but it doesn't really matter. Dark Law actually, spoiler alert, doesn't hit the card that I want to hit anyway. So 1-6, Dark Law's going to roll, hit 4, and banish an empowered Tiger Warrior. And I'm like, well, that's a card you don't want in your hand anyway, so not really much. Looking at TJ's hand, it's not a good position, because Masked Hero Dark Law at all. Because if he did have a way to get over Dark Law, he would be in a great position. He has the Call by the Grave for the Absolute Zero. He's in a great spot right now. He's going to use Tuning and Terraforming to search a Quick Draw Synchron, and as well as search an Empowered, Empowerment from his deck to his hand. So he has quite a few options. Unfortunately, all of them are going to be banished, so he's not in the best position. On the flip side, fortunately for him, he didn't banish any important cards. I'm going to go ahead and show him the mass change. Like, look, no matter what board you summon, I'm going to activate mass change, get rid of my Absolute Zero to summon Acid, and then it's going to wipe your board and banish it. He's going to go ahead and concede to that, even though he has Call by the Grave in his hand to stop the Absolute Zero. Now, granted, I don't think he still has anything for the Dark Law, and that could be the reason why he scooped, but I don't know, man. Sometimes you just got to push it forward. TJ is going to start off with Upstart Goblin, and I really wanted to show you guys this insane combo. So if you guys want to see this insane combo before you see the deck profile, let me know down below in the comment section. I'll probably include a different combo sequence for the deck profile. This is how three cards is going to get you a shooting Quasar Dragon. That is right, TJ is going to make a shooting Quasar Dragon in three cards, and on top of that, he's also going to draw six cards in the process. So he's going to ditch a Doppel Warrior, two Special Summon Quick Draw Synchron, as well as Normal Summon Junk Synchron, two Special Summon Doppel Warrior back to the side of the field. He's going to use both of those monsters, the Quick Draw and the Doppel Warrior, for a Synchro Summon of Junk Archer and two tokens to his side of the field. He's then going to follow up with the token and the Junk Archer for a Link Summon into his Isol, two Tales of the Noble Knights. Isol's effect, you send two equipped spell cards from his deck to his graveyard, Living Fossil. And also, what is the other card he's going to send? Probably Premature Burial, or, I'm sorry, the Premature card, whatever burial card it is. To Special Summon another copy of Doppel Boy from his deck to his side of the field. Now TJ is going to follow up by using Doppel Warrior and Junk Synchron for a Synchro Summon. This is where it's really important that you use those two monsters for the Synchro Summon, because your Isol is still on the field and you have to put it in the furthest most zone. So he's going to use those monsters for a Synchro Summon, and that is going to make his Excel Synchron to his side of the field, using Excel Synchron's effect, but not before getting two tokens to his side of the field, because Doppel Warrior was sent to the graveyard. He's going to send Jet Synchron from his deck to his graveyard, decreasing the level of his Excel Synchron. Now, when I told you guys to pick up Doppel Warriors, I was being serious, because Doppel Warrior is really important to the strategy, as you guys can see. He's going to follow up with the Excel Synchron and the token to make his TG Hyper Librarian, and this is where he's going to start drawing a lot of cards. Furthermore, he's going to go ahead and use the token plus the Isol to make Summon Sorceress to the opposite zone, to the leftmost token, or the furthest most token where his Doppel token is pointing to, and then use Summon Sorceress effect to Special Summon a level 1 monster from his deck to his side of the field, a level 1 warrior monster, which just so happens to be Sheen Squire. Now, Sheen Squire plus said token is going to be used for a Synchro Summon. Like, what are you doing? This combo sequence seems over. No, it isn't. He's going to go ahead and make Celestial Double Star Shaman. And if you guys ever wanted the card to buy out, that card is just too saucy. I knew it was going to be good, and now it's actually going to pay dividends. He's going to summon two Doppel Warriors back to his side of the field. TJ, what are you doing? Slow down. You got to cut it. He's going to use the Shaman and the Doppel Warrior for another Synchro Summon. That's going to go ahead and make his Krishtron Quandex, getting him two more tokens. And then the tokens plus the Krishtron Quandex is going to be used for another Synchro Summon. That's right. This man is just not stopping on his Synchro Summon capabilities, being able to summon any massive amount of monsters to his side of the field using both the Quandex and the token to make his second copy of TJ Hyper Librarian. Keep in mind, TJ has drawn quite a few cards just off of those three Synchro Summons, drawing three cards pretty good already, and he's not done Synchro Summoning. He's going to discard a card from his hand to spell summon his Jet Synchron that he previously sent to the graveyard to Excel Synchron and use those monsters for a Synchro Summon of Formula Synchron. Oh my god, that is three more cards. He just drew six cards. That is fucking awesome. I mean, I apologize my language, but that's still really good. Drawing six cards and making a Shooting Quasar Dragon. You don't even want to know how many hand traps he has, how many Called by the Grays he's drawn. That is phenomenal. And no, it looks like he's not done. He's going to use DDR, discarding a card from his hand to the graveyard, to special summon that Jet Synchron back to his side of the field. And it looks like he's going to follow up with the Jet Synchron plus the Doppel Warrior for another Synchro Summon. TJ, when does it stop? That's going to summon Marshall Metal Marcher to his side of the field, using its effect to special summon a Junk Synchron back to his side of the field, but not before he gets two tokens with his Doppel Warrior effect. Man, TJ, you are going in there. Now the Metal Marcher plus the two tokens are going to be used for another Synchro Summon. How many times are you going to Synchro Summon in one turn? This feels so reminiscent of 2010 format, Synchro format, Junk Doppel format, Dandy Warrior format. He's going to make Assault Block Wing, Sonoya the Rainstorm, and then use both of those monsters for a Quister Wing. Whoa. And three cards, plus his extenders, of course, he made a Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon, a Shooting Quasar Dragon, as well as a Summoned Sorceress, and he has six cards in hand. Wow, that is amazing. And if you guys want to see that, go and destroy that like button. Let's get to 150 likes, and let me know that you guys want to see that as a different combo tutorial for the deck profile. Let's shoot for 250 likes, guys. It's not that hard. I know we can do it. I'm actually decreasing from the 350 to the 250 because this deck is just insane, and I want to get it to you guys as fast as possible. Being able to summon this board like this with a back row, you know he has hand traps. You know I just can't break this board. I'm going to try, though. He's going to activate his empowerment. I don't really do nothing, but it's still like there. I don't know what to tell him about it. I'm going to start off with my turn. Then I'm going to activate Reinforcement of the Army. He's actually not going to negate the Reinforcement of the Army, so I'm pretty happy about that. I'm going to add Vision Hero Vion from my deck to my hand. And I do have the Elemental Hero Solid Soldier / Vision Hero Vion combo. But the problem with that is that he has two negates on his field. He has possible negates in his hand. He has possible negates face down. I'm not going to be able to play through five negates. It's not too many decks that can play through five negates, especially when some of those negates come from your hand. That is just too much. I'm going to activate Infinite Impermanence, targeting the Shooting Quasar Dragon, probably a last-ditch effort. I'm pretty sure I'm mentally I'm packing this one up. I'm not winning this game. It's not happening. I'm telling you guys. He didn't even Soul Charge me. He literally just three-card combo those monsters. Imagine if those monsters go away and he Soul Charged them back to his side of the field. This is a losing effort. I'm going to summon Solid Soldier. TJ, thinking about his game plan, I'm pretty sure he's going to negate it through the effects of Crystal Wing. And then it's a wrap. It's a wrap, guys. He's going to negate it through Crystal Wing. I don't have any more monster summons. His Quasar can attack twice. That's 8,000 on the board right now. Granted, I have 9,000, but he has a Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon, as well as a Summoned Sorceress to his side of the field. We're going to go into game three, fellas. Wow. Looking at that Synchro deck was too strong, but heroes do have a little bit of sauce on their self. Activating Emergency Call to get Elemental Hero Solid, or I'm sorry, not Vision Hero Vion. We're gonna get Elemental Hero Solid Soldier from my deck to my hand, and this is gonna set me up for some pretty big plays. Now, you guys have seen the combo tutorial for the Elemental Hero deck, and if you haven't, you're gonna see it now. So I'm gonna normal summon Solid Soldier to special summon Vision Hero Vion. This is gonna be a two card game ender against most decks. Seriously. Vision Hero Vion plus Elemental Hero Solid Soldier will win you games. Solid Soldier is gonna go ahead, or Vion is gonna go ahead and say Destiny or Malicious. And then Malicious effect is gonna activate itself banishing itself from the graveyard to spell summon another one from the deck to the side of the field. Now, both Visionero Vion and Destiny Hero Malicious are going to be used for a link summon. That's going to go ahead and make Isol two Tails of the Noble Knights. And then Isol's effect is going to activate, possibly to add a Elemental Hero, an Elemental Hero Onisneos from my deck to my hand. Now, I'm going to go ahead and follow up with Isol's other effect, sending four equipped spell cards from my deck to the graveyard. And that's going to go ahead and special summon Elemental Hero Shadow Mist from my deck to my side of the field. We're in a good light, especially since TJ just so happened to not draw any of his hand traps, and he plays a good amount of hand traps to draw him on his opening turn. I'm gonna go ahead and summon Shadow Mist effect to add match change from my deck to my hand. And then we're gonna go ahead and follow up with the Destiny Hero Malicious again, going ahead and banishing itself to special summon another copy from my deck to my side of the field. I've already gotten rid of every single one of my bricks. Now I'm going to use the Isol plus the Destiny Hero Malicious for another link summon back into our summon sorceress. I apologize, European players, but we do have a combo for European players that allows you to get similar results with just one additional card. Actually, the exact same results with one more card. So I'm going to go ahead and special summon Attack Gainer to my side of the field, and then use Solid Soldier and Attack Gainer for that 3,200 Notoria piece. Too strong. That's good. It's only 3,200 for one turn, but it's still good. Next, we are going to basically set the match change face down. And that's it. I'm going to set more cards face down, and that's it, folks. That's it. I really don't see this deck coming out of it. He doesn't play any Kaijus, at least not in his main board. I'm going to match change the Shadow Mist and turn it into a Dark Law and add Solid Soldier from my deck to my hand. Thank you guys so much for watching another segment of the Galley Effect. This was actually an epic matchup. To be honest with you guys, it was who won that die roll and if you open consistently. We just so happened to open consistent in these three games and I happened to win that die roll, but it's a really good game. I really appreciate you guys for watching. If you did, again, give it a like. Just let us know that you enjoyed it and also share it with a friend. Please like, comment, subscribe, but most of all, enjoy. I hope you guys are having a great day like I am.